Good morning.
Good morning.
In behalf of Julie and Cornerstone Church, Pastor Todd, myself, we welcome you today in honor of Don Chapuzio, and we pray that you be consoled through the Word of God, through prayer, and through the music today. And we just ask God's blessing. Heavenly Father, we thank you and we praise you today. Thank you for your goodness and your tender mercies, and especially for your grace, God. And Father, I pray that you would touch every heart in this place today, that you would use the ministers, that you would use one another, God, to console. And may the love of God just be manifest in this place. And Father, we'll give you all the glory and all of the honor in your Son's name, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Would you join with Dee as she leads us in Amazing Grace?
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. T'was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. When we've been there 10,000 years, thank you, Jesus. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we know less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Listen, praise God, 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 praise God. Praise God, praise God, praise God.
I once was lost.
I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
I was blind, but now I see. What a phrase. I want to give you some hope this morning. Not only hope, but assurance. And this is what the scripture says. It's so consoling because so many people today wonder, after this life ends, is there a beginning for me? And what will that beginning be? I want you to listen to these words of comfort from God's word. It's found in Romans chapter 10. It says here that if we confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus, and we believe in our heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture says, whoever believes on him will not be put to shame. He says, whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. There's such assurance there in those scriptures, and it takes away all doubt, and it puts hope and assurance in our heart. And I want to encourage you today, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved. In honor of Donald Trapuzio today, Donald passed away to be with the Lord and with his friends and family that preceded him. Don was born in Bessemer, Michigan, the son of William Paul Trapuzio, Sr. and Gertrude Agnes Trapuzio. Don attended A.D. Johnson High School in Bessemer, Michigan. In his early working career, he was a certified auto mechanic. He worked at Fisher Body, which is downstate, and later he drove a log truck for Steigers and Carl Niemi. Don volunteered his time to help with a catastrophic cleanup for the disaster of Hurricane Katrina. Don was preceded in death by a brother William, a sister Teresa, a nephew Greg, a nephew Kevin, a daughter, and a baby grandson, Jordan. Don was one surviving sister, Diane. And with his friend and first wife, Kathy Critcher, they had two children that Don was very proud of. The firstborn was Jamie, and a daughter, Crystal. And by loving inheritance, surviving wife, Julie Trapuzio, daughter, Jerry, a son, William, and a daughter, Robin. And Don is also survived by many grandchildren and great-grandchildren, nieces and nephews. Honorable mention for a nephew, Billy Trapuzio, and Kim Kruger, and Mr. John Freddy, and his medical assistant, Kristen, and a longtime friend, Chris Pogliano. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your words of comfort today. And God, that we don't have to have our hearts to be troubled, because we believe in God. And we also believe in Jesus Christ, God's Son. We thank you, Lord, that he is the way and the truth and the life. And God, that you made that a very narrow way, that it's only through your Son, Jesus Christ, that we can be saved, and that we can have the hope of heaven and being reunited with our loved ones. And to this, God, we thank you. And we thank you for the comfort of your word today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thanks, Pastor. Well, I'm Pastor Todd, and I just thought I'd share a few things with you this morning. You know, it says that this life is filled with great days and difficult days, huh? Think about that. I was looking when Pastor Roy was reading the obituary, and I was looking at those dates up there. Isn't that something? Out of every person that's ever been born or ever lived in this world, we all have some things in common. There's a day that we're born. For Don, it was October 23rd of 1944. And then there's a day that every one of us will, none of us have experienced that second day there, have we? But that day is coming, because we know that we have that in common with everyone, right? Denise was in my office just a couple hours ago, and she was talking, and she brought up something I thought was so good. I said, I think you should share that. And she said, I think you need to. And so I'm going to share it with you. 2 years ago, almost to the date, Don was here. But he wasn't here just for a service. He was here because his stepdaughter, Beth, had died. And he was here for her funeral. And you know, I was thinking that after Denise said that to me, I was thinking, I wonder if, and I know he didn't, but just think of that with me today. Did he have any kind of understanding that 2 years from now, he wouldn't be coming in the door, you guys would be coming in the door? He had 2 years left. I heard something yesterday on the radio I thought was good. I thought it was talking about this lady, and this lady had a boy, and her boy had cancer. And she said, you know what cancer taught us? Because her son dealt with cancer for 8 years. And she said, you know what we realized? Is cancer makes every day valuable. And we begin to realize that every day is compressed into value. And so today we are those that live in this valuable days. So what do we do with the days that we have? You know, Pastor Roy just read Don's obituary, and think of all the days he had. Think of the days that he experienced that, you know, his children were born. Great days. Incredible days. Days that you as parents know that you don't forget those days. Days that you think back on and you say, wow, was that incredible. My son's gone this weekend, and so we're watching his little two little kids, and one of them's two and one of them's about 3 months, him and Kelsey. And I was thinking last night how incredible gift of life is, and those are the days you hold on to and the days you wish they don't go too quickly. He had days like that, and then he had days that were difficult days. Losing a child. You don't forget those days. In all of those, it says that we've been called to live them. And to what Pastor Roy said is you need to have hope. If you don't have hope, you can't live. So he had days where he showed up. I mean, I can't even imagine he shows up at the Hurricane Katrina and sees the devastation. He showed up there to help in the midst of chaos and devastation. Yeah. All of those days make up a life, right? Days that you drove truck, and days that you got married, and days you had children, and days that you lived. Days you rode motorcycle. Joey said he loved to ride his Goldwing. Think of those days, just enjoying being a part of that and experiencing hunting and fishing and all those. That's what part of life is, and that's what Jesus said, I come that you might have life and life worth living. And so when you look ahead, you say, wow, God, there has to be some great things ahead for me. Ten days before the last day there, 9/21, he died on a Wednesday. I remember seeing the ambulance go through Bessemer, and I thought, I wonder where the ambulance is going. 10 days before that, he came here on a Sunday morning. And so I saw him, and he certainly didn't look good. And those of you that saw Don in those last months of his life, you could tell that he was not doing very well. And so I met him. I just, once in a while, I get to the back, and I stood out on the sidewalk. It was a beautiful day. And so I stood out on the sidewalk, and I said to him, I greeted him. And here's the question I ask him, and this is a question I want to ask you, and I'm not going to talk a long time. So here's the question I asked him when he came down the ramp that you walked up on. Here's the question I want you to think about today. I said, Don, are you right with God? Are you right with God? Just a simple. And I'll never forget his response to me that day. He said, that's what I'm here for, Pastor. I need to get right with God. And so the ramp is lined up, but I could care less who's waiting. And they could have cared less because they knew something God was doing there. And so I said to him, I said, it's a day to get right. And I said, could I pray with you? And so we stood at the end of the ramp and prayed. I don't know if he knew how many days he had left. I didn't know how many. But here's what, are you right with God? Because there was a coming a day. It won't be 9/21 of 22, but it will be a day. It will be a day for me, and it will be a day for you. And the only thing that day, when you meet that day, you will need to know that you are right with God. And it's just simply this, that he's forgiven me. Isn't it something that we can, I'm just absolutely amazed at the incredible, Denise sang about it, the grace of God, but the patience of God. And he's constantly in there saying, oh, you don't have to carry this kind of weight. You know the weight that every one of us carry? None of us are exempt from it. Is the weight of messed up days, of days that we've made mistakes, of days that we say, man, if I had that to do over again. Oh, when I was a boy, I used to play in the front. We lived out on the farm, and we had a bunch of neighborhood kids, and we used to play kickball, and I put, you want to talk about intelligent, I took cement blocks and buried them out in the field because I thought they would make good bases, and they did until people slid into them. And then they had gashes in their legs, and they're like, who made up this idea of cement blocks buried in sand? But we used to play kickball, and you know, you'd kick at the ball, and you'd miss the ball, and immediately every one of us would yell, do over, do over. And if we played with some buddies of ours and they had grace, they'd say, yeah, okay, we'll let you kick again. Isn't it amazing that God says, oh, I let you do this over again? Oh, yeah, come on. You swung, you missed it, you ended up on your back, you're full of dirt. Ah, come on, get up. Take another kick. You see, the amazing thing is that every day is a chance to do it over again and say, oh, I messed up. God, would you forgive me? Would you just forgive me? And, oh, there's a lot of garbage in my past and a lot of places I messed up and people messed up and they did me wrong, but I forgive them. Would you forgive me? And that's all it is. That's what you get right with God over. And it's because of this. It's because of Jesus. So the wonderful thing is that every one of us have been born for a purpose, and the purpose is to know God, and the way that we know God is simply through the gift of his son Jesus, who came and who lived and who died and who rose again, and who one day, here's a scripture I read this morning, it says, I give them eternal life and nothing will snatch them out of my hands. And so when people experience eternal life, nothing has the ability to snatch them out of their hands. It's new life. It's living with joy. It's living with peace. It's living saying, man, I don't have to hold things against people. Last Sunday morning, I was standing back there by the soundboard and I was talking with somebody. And all of a sudden the doors were open and somebody walked in and the sun was shining and I couldn't quite see them. And so I was looking and I thinking, why? And here it's this kid I grew up with. He was my first cousin, and he lived on the farm a quarter mile away from where we lived. Him and his wife, they live 200 miles from here, and all of a sudden they just show up. I'm like, Barry, what are you doing? He said, I had to come. I went to Barry's farm about 7 years ago on a Thanksgiving day because I felt like God told me to go there. And I sat with him and I just said the simple question, do you right with God? And his wife said, no, I'm not right with God. I've been through so much stuff. And that day she experienced Christ, but not Barry. Barry still struggled with addiction and still struggled with all this stuff. But here, one night in August, he was sitting up. He works really a lot, but he couldn't go to sleep, and he was sitting up, and he was watching old YouTube videos, and he came across an old Billy Graham crusade on a YouTube video, and he said, I don't know what happened, Todd, but he said, I met God that night. He forgave me. He said this to me. We stood out here after church, and he stood in the parking lot before he got in his car to drive back home. He said, for 46 years, he said, I was an angry man. I was just angry about everything. Did he have a right to be angry? Oh, yeah. He did. He went through a lot. Lost his dad when he was just a young man. His dad got cancer, and he died when his dad was 49. He said, man, I need my dad. All this stuff had happened in his life, and he was just angry. But one night, God showed up. And you know what he said to me? He said, I used to go out to my machine shop, and he said, I used to just scream at the top of my lungs. No one else could hear him. And he said, I used to just scream at God. And I used to just taunt him and curse him. And he said, you know what he said to me in a text this week? He said, he must have just got tired of listening to me curse him because he wouldn't let me go. He doesn't let any of us go. He doesn't care. Doesn't care what you say against him. He says, I care what I've done for you, and what I've done for you has already been done, and nothing can do take that away. And so it simply comes there. You know Christ. You know a way. You know, I said one time, I said, Jesus didn't come for people to have a place to show up on a Sunday morning. Sometimes people believe that that's all he came for, is so we could have a place to show up on a Sunday morning. That's just going through motions. That's just going through motions. Jesus said, man looks at the external, but God's looking at your heart. He's looking at your heart, every one of us today. He's looking at our heart. Is your heart filled with anger? Is it filled with regret? Is it filled with bitterness against somebody? Is it filled with hatred? Is it filled with anger toward him? God's not offended with you. He loves you. And so, I'm so thankful that day that Don said, yeah, I'm here because I need to get right with God. I hope you believe what I'm telling you, because it's the absolute truth. Some people think I make up stuff. I don't make up stuff. I just live on the front row of grace, the front row of mercy, the front row where I see. My dad used to have a saying when I was a boy, come here, Todd, I'm going to give you what you deserve. And hear me, I deserved everything I got because I did mess up when I was a kid. I'm so glad my Heavenly Father doesn't say that to me. He doesn't say, Todd, come here. You messed up over there. He doesn't come and say, I want to rub your nose in your garbage. He never says that. He just says, come on over here, Todd. Yeah, you messed up. You know what? Yeah, I do. You need me to forgive you? Yeah, I do. And then he shows up. No matter how many times I call, he always shows up. He just shows up. So today is here. This morning is here. We've come to remember a life, but I pray that you experience the wonderful truth of Jesus today, that he loves you. And his plans are good for you. And he doesn't keep a record of wrongs. When you know forgiveness, you know everything. So would you just bow your heads with me today? Would you do that? Could you just do that? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for grace that goes beyond what we can even imagine. Thank you for your mercy today. Today's a day of mercy for people. God, you know hearts in this place that are hurting. You know lives that have just been through a lot of stuff. And it feels like it's almost more than they can even bear up under. And so today I ask you that you would come close to them. That they would sense, Jesus, that you're not far from them, but you sit right in the next seat to him. Would you just put your arm around him? Would you show him that, God, you're close to those who have hearts that are broken and hurting, thank you for you come when I call and you do miracles because you're faithful. So we just bless you, God. For people today that need forgiveness, God, would you just come? Just ask him to forgive you right now. Just ask him to take off all this weight and all this sin and all this garbage. Just ask him. He says, if you call on him and you ask him, he'll come. He'll forgive you and he'll fill you. Now would you fill people? You're forgiving them right now. The Lord's forgiving you. You don't have to live with like a death sentence around you or over you. He's forgiving you because he loves you. Perfect love. Today, push in through all the clouds, all the things that people have believed about you. Would you push in today? Thank you that Don got right with you. Thank you that, God, you took it all and you gave him hope. Now you give him eternal life. Thank you that you do beyond what we can even imagine. So would you do it for people in this place today? Because you're so good, God. Wow. You're a good father. You know everything that everyone in this place needs today. So would you just, God, even today, God, release them and set them free? Would you set them free from hatred and anger and bitterness and bondages and all those things, selfishness, guilt and shame? Would you just set them free right now, Jesus? Fill them today. I declare over you today the filling of his presence, of his joy and his peace. You're going to notice a miraculous thing. Some of you are going to notice a miraculous thing tonight when you go to bed. You're going to feel a peace that you've never known before. And you're going to remember what I just said this morning here. You're going to know that you are no longer an orphan. You're no longer alone. You're no longer living just unprotected. But he's surrounding you and he's filling you with his peace and his joy. And if that's you today, just simply agree with him. Say, yes, yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus, do that. Just say, yes, Jesus, do that for me. Do that for me today. Just keep your heads bowed and your eyes closed and let the Lord minister to you today. He's coming to heal hearts that are hurting and lives that are just, if you look at the past and you think it's nothing but a chaos, it's a wreck, but he's coming to heal that place. Denise is going to sing a song here, and God is going to come and minister to you, but if you just wait on him and just be with your heads bowed, your eyes closed, that you would just feel his peace and his presence come close to you.
It will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Yeah. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes, when I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. can all imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I say hallelujah, and I be able to speak at all? I can only is forever worship you. I can only imagine
since the Lord speaking that there's someone here that thinks you're too far, there's no hope for you. You've went too far and you've done too much, and it seems like the exterior around your life is so hard that nothing will be able to break that. And the Lord would say to you that no matter what or how you feel, He is greater. He is bigger, and that hard exterior is going to just crumble one day, and He's going to just reveal Himself to you. So we just bless you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you that no one's too far. We just say you alone. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah, amen. Well, you're going to experience some things today that you know are going to be God, because he has your number, and He is going to show Himself. And especially tonight, some of you are going to go to sleep and you're going to feel some things that you're going to like, wow. And isn't that amazing? Because I see that often. Won't you stand with me? Would you do that? There's some... The family has asked if you would come and have lunch with them downstairs, and so they would hope that you would be able to do that. So. So on behalf of myself and Pastor Roy and Denise and this team that ministers here at Cornerstone, we just want to thank you for coming and being our guest today here and being a part of the funeral service for Don and blessing his family by your attendance. So thanks so much. This concludes our memorial service this morning. So come downstairs and enjoy some lunch.